Now that you know how many devices you are communicating to, it's time to select your licensing options. In this video, I'll be focusing on the software license with the native HTML5 clients. There are still part numbers for a USB license dongle and legacy client types, but licensing can be more complex in those situations. I recommend reaching out to Schneider Electric directly if these are needed. First, let's select a server license. The licensing is based on the number of points in the system. Specifically, these are the variable tags that I'm reading from a physical device in the field. We'll talk about tags much more later in the series, but if I'm reading current, voltage, power, and a trip alarm from a breaker, that's 4 points. Estimating your total number of tags is the most difficult part of this process. As a few estimates, a basic energy meter may have fewer than 50 tags. A power quality meter with onboard alarms has closer to 150, and a full branch circuit monitor has over 700 useful tags. The licenses only have a few tiers to choose from. You may have a license with 500, 1500, 15,000, and unlimited points. As you can see, it doesn't take many high-end devices to pass 15,000 tags, so most projects end up with unlimited tags. Next, we'll add some control clients to our license. Each license allows one web browser client to access the server at a time. If you have 10 workstations but only 5 client licenses, any 5 of the 10 may be connected at once. As soon as one disconnects, another can log in. The clients should be licensed with the same number of tags as the server. You may also have some add-on modules like the Event Notification module, Advanced Reports and Dashboards, or Advanced Reporting modules. These can be added to your license order. Finally, a redundant system adds a bit of complexity. The standby server must have a full server license with the same number of points as the primary server. However, clients only require a redundant client license, which always has unlimited points. The number of redundant client licenses should still match the primary server. If you have purchased the Event Notification module, you'll want a second module license to run on the standby server as well. Advanced Reports and Dashboards does not support redundancy, so it will only run on one server or the other. In practice, this module is generally run on its own separate server to spread out the server load, and we'll see this in the next video. At this point, you should be able to place an order for your software license. Next, we'll identify what type of server and supporting software is necessary before installation. Until then, thank you.